Hello everyone. Excel training for professionals. For complete video on basics and advanced Excel, please contact me at the given email ID or phone number. We'll do VLOOKUP today. It is a very useful formula and one of the most important formula in Excel. So let us understand VLOOKUP. Before getting into the formula, we will do some exercise to understand why VLOOKUP and its importance. We have got some sample data here: serial number, employee code, employee name, their year and salary. Okay, now suppose you want to know the employee name of these employee codes. One can simply look for this code in this data starting from top and will copy it like this. 20055, again same. So this is one of the way. Another way, one can use the find function. Say 20066. Okay. Again, same for 20045. Same thing, 20045. So this is another way, but it will not be feasible in case the data is large. It will take a lot of time. So here we can apply VLOOKUP. Now let us understand VLOOKUP. Equals to VLOOKUP, open bracket, our first parameter lookup value. Lookup value is the value you are looking for, or the common value. You can call it the common value, which is common in both the data. In our case, it will be the employee code. Employee code, this will be the lookup value. Okay, table array. Table array is the area where you will look for this code. So in this case, it will be employee code and employee name. This will be my table array. Column index number. Now let us understand column index number. Here the common field or the lookup value is employee code. So it will always be the first column, and rest of the corresponding values, employee name, year and salary, will be second, third and fourth and accordingly. So in column index number, we'll specify the position of the corresponding value from the lookup value. In this case, it is in the second position. So we'll specify the position as 2. The last parameter, range lookup. We'll write 0 here and I'll explain later why 0. So let us start VLOOKUP. Equals to VLOOKUP, lookup value employee code, table array. Table array is employee code and employee name. Column index number 2 comma 0. Enter. So you have got the result. Now let us understand what's the formula. H8, that is H8 employee code. So we are trying to say look up for employee code in B6 to C15. B6 to C15. So look up for 20066. And if it is found, or well, if it is available, we want the corresponding value, which is in the second position. So 2, the employee name, then comma 0. Now I will freeze the selection using F4. F4. I hope everybody know the use of F4, why we freeze the selection. Okay, we have got the result. $2.25 is not available, so we are getting a NA value. So this is the basic VLOOKUP formula, and it has got three conditions, so we'll understand them one by one. First one, lookup value should be unique. Lookup value should be unique. What does it mean? Okay. In our case, employee code 20066 is appearing more than appearing twice. So what happens is VLOOKUP looks for the code from top to bottom. It starts the search from top to bottom, and the value which is appearing first will be picked. In this case, Bacon Junior. So it is appearing first in the table array. Now suppose if I change this code to say 20055, automatically my value will change. So this is the problem. If in case your lookup value is not unique, so you have to ensure that your lookup value is unique, and we'll learn also how to deal with a non-unique data. Suppose your lookup value is not unique, how we can apply VLOOKUP in such a case? We'll learn it in part 2. Okay, the second condition, corresponding value should be to the left of lookup value. Corresponding value. In this case, the corresponding value is employee name. It should be to the left of employee code or to the right side of the user. There is a problem with left and right, so I'll explain using the address of the cell. If your common value or the lookup value is in column B, you can pick any value from C, from column C, from column D, from column E, F, G, H, any value. But suppose your lookup value, suppose the employee code is in this column, column D, and now you want to pick the employee name or the serial number, you cannot pick using VLOOKUP. It cannot be from D to C. It can always be from C to D, C to E, C to F. It cannot be from D to C, D to B, or D to A. It cannot be like this. It should always be from here to it should be like this. So this is what the second condition is. The third condition, table array selection should begin with lookup value column. Okay. Now see, our table array in this case is from B6 to C15 from employee code. It has started from employee code. In whenever you apply VLOOKUP, your selection of table array should always start with the common value or the lookup value column. It cannot start from this column. Suppose if I write A instead of B, then this area contains the employee code, but we'll not get our result because the formula has been designed accordingly. So the table array selection should always start with the lookup value column, in this case employee code, the common value. So this is the basic VLOOKUP formula. Okay, another aspect, the last parameter, why zero? Okay, let us understand why zero. We will use zero if we are looking for an exact match, that is exactly 20066. If you are looking for exactly 20066, you will write zero. And one more thing, we can also use 1 instead of 0, but before that you have to keep in mind one important thing, that is your data should be sorted on the basis of common value in ascending order. In this case, the common value or the lookup value is employee code, and your data should always be sorted in ascending order in case you are applying anything other than 0. So we'll sort our data first. Now instead of 0, I will write 1. Now 1 indicates approximate match. See, 200055 was not available when I was applying 0. We were getting error, but now I have got a value. Now let us understand this. I have sorted my data in ascending order. We'll use 1 instead of 0 only when we are looking for approximate match and my data is sorted in ascending order, and the data should be sorted on the basis of lookup value or the common value. Okay, now since 20025 is not available in this tuple array, and 1 using 1 indicates approximate match, what happens is any value which is very close to 20025 will be picked. In this case, 20023 is very close to 20025, and close in the sense it should be less than or equal to the lookup value. Suppose I change this to 20026, it is also very close to 20025, but it will not be picked because any value which is less than or equal to the lookup value will be picked as an approximate match. So this is what 0, the application of 0 and 1 in the last parameter. 0 indicates that you are looking for an exact match and your data may not be sorted in ascending order, but 1 indicates that you are looking for an approximate match and your data is sorted in ascending order, otherwise you will get a incorrect result. So that's it in the basic VLOOKUP formula. For complete video on advanced and basics, you can contact me at the given email ID or phone number. So thank you.